Greetings. I am Dictor Van Doomcock, the future ruler of Earth, and I'm afraid it's time for a good old-fashioned rant. I have been informed that there are a bunch of sad, deluded bits of human refuse on Twitter who have been straight-up assaulting William Shatner. I had to be informed of this from third parties because Shatner blocked me for some reason that defies human understanding, given my relentless love for and support of the man and what he represents to Star Trek and to Western civilization. But you know what? As we say on Earth, c'est la vie. If only he hadn't blocked me, I'd be in there fighting these pieces of rancid rat shit by his side. But since he has blocked me, I can only comment on what's going on, and the only way that I can comment at this point is to rant. Because these nattering nabobs of nothing that fester like colonies of colonic crud in social media these days are absolutely the lowest forms of life on the Twitter sphere. I'm not going to descend to calling them out by name. If you want to see their names and respond to them, you'll find them by following at DataRacer117 on Twitter, or by following me at Doomcock on Twitter, since I retweeted his post, which features all of the unredacted images you'll see referenced here in this video. But I am going to rant about these scumbag pieces of filth as a public service, just to give you some idea of exactly what is passing for discourse today in the dark corners of the Twitterverse. So right off the bat, some pathetic clown sent William Shatner a message that reads, "Hot take, I wish at the real Nimoy was alive rather than Shatner." While I share at least part of this sentiment, as I do wish Leonard Nimoy was still alive, I ask you, what kind of worthless bottom-of-the-barrel piece of trash posts something like this? What is the point of it? So many people these days rant about hate speech on the internet. Speech that is directed at someone because of who they are. And yet, why isn't this considered hate speech? This is a message that literally has no point to it, no idea behind it, no underlying social value or commentary to it other than hate. Its sole purpose is to communicate a hateful idea, to insult or injure William Shatner just for being William Shatner. It doesn't even criticize Shatner for anything he's done or anything he's said. It's simply an expression of hatred that does nothing for Nimoy or his family. It merely throws hatred towards a man who is beloved the world over. Is this reprehensible? Indeed, yes, it is. But it's merely the cherry on top of the shit sundae that is to follow. Buckle up, gang. It gets bumpy from here. An intellectually deficient lump of ass putty, I'll call M, says, "At William Shatner, do you realize that you are an old white man trying to insult young folks who have a brighter future ahead of them than you'll ever do?" First of all, M, when you're insulting someone like William Shatner, and you say that you and your little play pals, quote, have a brighter future ahead of them than you'll ever do, you're laughable. You're on a par with the silliest clown that ever got hit in the face with a pie by a monkey in a tutu. You're absolutely nothing compared to William Shatner. None of your little pals will ever achieve a tenth of what William Shatner has. I know that you think you're a star because everybody on Twitter thinks that they're stars, desperately wants to be a star, needs the constant acclaim of likes from followers like some sad masturbating monkey starving to death in a lab cage with nothing to his name but a cocaine dispenser and a mirror while scientists track his demise and the whole time he thinks he's king of the world. But I assure you, you're not a star. You're a leech, desperately and futilely attempting to attach itself to the ass of a star you'll never meet. You and your little friends think you, quote, have a brighter future ahead of them than you'll ever do. Not with grammar like that. No, if you can't even write a tweet properly, stardom is just that much more out of your grasping grasp. Objectively, you'll never be an internationally famous actor, author, multimillionaire, cult figure, recording artist, director, producer. So how exactly do you little nothings have a brighter future ahead of them than you'll ever do? Oh sure, he'll die before you because he's older. But your whole you'll ever do thing implies you're grading on the metric of lifetime achievement. And I guarantee you, sight unseen, you will never approach Shatner's achievements, success, following, charisma, and to suggest otherwise is laughable. The delusion of a generation that always got medals for participating. Ribbons just for showing up and failing. Ta-da! That's not how medals and ribbons actually get handed out in life, and once you get out there and start living it, you'll be in for a rude awakening. But see, then a whole bunch of these same little hive-minded nothings get in on the act and reveal something about themselves and their know-nothing generation that is absolutely critical to understanding how delusional these cretins are. These people assume that their own ignorance is actually an arbiter of fact, that because they, in their extremely limited knowledge, don't know something, they assume the something they don't know is either irrelevant or non-existent, as if their own lack of education and information actually shapes reality itself, their lack of awareness of a thing making it cease to exist. In previous generations, when people became aware that they didn't know something, they realized it was a deficiency and set out to learn it. This generation of turds, however, believe that when they discover they don't know something, they dismiss it as not worth knowing. Or they disbelieve it, deny it, or mock it. It's absolutely astonishing to me that these morons take so much pride in knowing so little. One little turd says, "Known worldwide? I can bet your ass that if I walk down the street now and ask random people if they know Mr. Shatner, their answer will be no. I'll bet you're an idiot, and I'll win." But let's amend that point. If you walk down the street and show random people a picture of Captain Kirk, how many people do you think won't know who that is? Then you'll be eating shit along with your crow, as Captain Kirk is one of the most identifiable icons of the 20th century, and the 21st century thus far, for that matter. Though, once enough cretins like you multiply, I'm sure all of our history and culture will be forgotten, since none of you have the attention span of an ADHD flea hooked on Star Trek Discovery. And suddenly, the sum total of our cultural history will be reduced to what happened last week. Because that'll be all that you can remember. Then another mental midget says, "Never heard of him until last year, so yikes, not much of an icon." Actually, I think the proper conclusion to that logical thread is, yikes, you are pathetically ignorant and out of touch. You probably need to, as Shatner would say, get a life and stop glorifying your own lack of knowledge as a virtue. It's not. The fact that you don't know shit doesn't make the shit irrelevant. It makes you irrelevant. This idiot, I'm calling M, then goes on to say, quote, "Who knew one tweet calling out Shatner's privilege would lead to homophobia and sexism in less than 10 minutes? Yeah, if Shatner is privileged, it's because he earned it. He's not living a dream you'll never even glimpse in person because he's a white male. He's living it because he's Captain Kirk, and T.J. Hooker, and Denny Crane. And he's an icon of our civilization, a civilization you disparage because you're entirely ignorant of it. And FYI, you won't find a shred of homophobia or sexism in this video, because it doesn't exist, and because on the basis of the facts alone, your obnoxious and ignorant posts can be dissected and ridiculed as the garbage that they are. I have blurred the names and identities of these fools because individually, they're irrelevant. The larger implications of these tweets are what truly matter here. Beyond a doubt, these people are representative of the so-called SJWs you find on social media. One wonders, how can you promote social justice for mankind when you harbor so much hatred for mankind. These tweets further no social justice agenda. They do not make a case for equality, for openness, for compassion. No. These tweets and those spewing them out like vomit into the world are pure undistilled hatred masquerading as virtue. As if attacking a man in his 80s for being white, male, and alive is going to bring about a revolution of enlightenment and tolerance in this world. Tolerance. That's what these people pretend to fight for. But these filthy weasels are among the most intolerant people you will ever find. Instead of trying to enlighten people as to their viewpoint, they attack. Instead of making the case for their cause, they abuse and degrade. This is the face of the cowardly new world being birthed in the petri dish of antisocial media. It is loathsome in a way that no creature of nature, no matter how repugnant, could ever be. A leech, a lamprey, a mosquito, these are all hellacious things, no doubt. But none of them captures just how worthless these scumbags are because they act from instinct, not hatred. As a final point, M says, what the fuck is ageist? Reversed racism doesn't exist. Yeah. Keep telling yourself that as you attack white males for their race and you attack old men for being old. That's the bottom line. You and your little pals are spreading the exact kind of hate you pretend to fight against. And until everyone is treated equally and judged not by the color of or wrinkles in their skin, but by the content of their characters, we will never be free. You will always be loathsome hypocrites, and irony of ironies, you'll call everyone else in the world haters, except yourselves. From the center of the earth, this is Dictor Van Doomcock, and I don't have to bid you all, my friends, to stay angry.